So I just got through watching a videotape. I hadn't seen this thing in years, and it's some young guy asking Maxine Waters, the congresswoman who has served this area now for like 35 years, why is it that we have all this gang violence? And Maxine Waters said, I don't really know. I'm not really sure, but and proceeded to basically say, well, whatever it is, the answer is spend more money. Now, we have a 50% dropout rate in the inner city. About a third of young black men have criminal records. And the problem is that the left-wing policies pushed by people like Maxine Waters have created fatherless communities. That's what's going on here. And what's bizarre is you ask people like Maxine Waters what's going on, and they will honestly say, and I think she is being sincere, I don't know. You never thought about it, Maxine? You never analyzed it? Why is it getting worse? Why is it that that over the last 50 years, when in 1965, 25% of black kids were born outside of wedlock, now it's 75%. Why is it getting worse? How can you explain that? I mean, clearly the country is less racist now than it was 50 years ago. How can you explain that? And they've got no answers. And the reason they have no answers is because the real answer is look into the freaking mirror. Left-wing policies have basically allowed women to marry the government and allowed men to abandon their financial and moral responsibility and the self-esteem and self-respect that goes along with it. And so you have a community with a bunch of people coming from fatherless homes, and to the degree that there are homes where they are fathers, these kids from fatherless homes have a different culture, a different attitude that offsets and undermines the other culture. And it's not just Larry Elder having some Eurocentric values looking down on people. I quote you one Barack Hussein Obama, who said before he became president, a kid growing up without a father is 5 times more likely to be poor, 9 times more likely to drop out of school, 20 times more likely to end up in jail. Hello! I didn't say it, he did. And so that brings us back to this so-called black leadership. If there was a crime for malpractice, these people would be on death row. I've been on the air 20 years. In 20 years, I have not been able to get Maxine Waters to come on. I wrote her a very respectful letter. I have it on my blog, The Elder Statement. Wrote it in 2001. And I asked her, why is it that you have the wrong attitude about crime? You think poverty causes crime. Really the other way around. Crime causes poverty. I'll give you an example. There is an area in the greater Boston area called Roxbury. Primarily an all-black area. There's an area right next to it, an adjacent area, called South Boston. They both have the same percentage of poverty, same percentage of welfare recipients, same percentage of kids coming from single-parent homes. However, the crime rate in Roxbury is substantially higher than the crime rate in South Boston. So even though you come from a home where you have no father, and you come from a home where you have no father compared to another ethnic group, the one that comes from the black home still seems to have more problems. So part of that are people like Maxine Waters. During the riots, the last LA riots, you have Maxine Waters standing up there saying, no justice, no peace. Are you kidding me? There's a YouTube video of Martin Luther King chastising black people for burning down their own neighborhoods, talking about how what it does to the property values and how it does what it does to deter people from coming into the community and doing commerce. And when MLK died, I know I'm digressing a little bit, but when MLK died, there was one of these accidental experiments because in part of the country, as is almost always the case, there's rain. Other parts of the country, there's no rain. So when MLK died, there were some communities that experienced rain, and there were some communities that didn't have rain. Where they didn't have rain, rioters went out and rioted. I grew up in a cold weather climate. I spent a lot of my time in a cold weather climate in Cleveland, and people tell me that crime goes down when it snows because people don't want to be inconvenienced. So rioters don't tend to riot when there's rain. So there were some areas in 1968 when MLK was assassinated that rained, and there was no riots. Well, fast forward 20 years later, we're able to look at those property values and compare them to the communities that had the riots, to the communities that didn't have any riots, demographically adjusted so that you're comparing like to like. And it turns out, surprise, surprise, the communities that did not experience rioting have higher property values and lower insurance premiums. Hello! By the way, Spike Lee recently said that he didn't like gentrification. That's when white people come into areas that were predominantly black areas, like Harlem and like the Bronx. And he said that Isn't it interesting how city services didn't improve until all these whites started moving in? I think it's interesting that black people march into that voting booth like lemmings and pull the lever 95% for black people while they're getting shitty services. But that's just me. But getting back to Spike, so what Spike really is doing is he's discouraging property appreciation in black communities by telling people, we don't want you moving in here. Meanwhile, he's living upscale, up on one, it's either Upper East Side or Upper West Side, I think it's Upper East Side, living in a Manhattan, living in a mansion that I read recently was listed for $32.5 million. That's right, $32.5 million, while talking about how the white man is oppressing the black man. It's a joke. Anyway, Maxine Waters, getting back to her, the reason she's clueless about why we have gang violence is because she has conspired with a bunch of other left-wing people, black and white, and sometimes even with Republicans, to grow the welfare state and to make people increasingly dependent upon it, with all of the bad things that flow from it. And it's not just me. Tupac Shakur, that well-known neocon, in that documentary called Resurrection, he said, white people probably like hearing people like me say this, but I know for a fact, if I had had a father when I was growing up, I would have had more discipline and I would have been more confident. Now, this is a guy that you would think was oozing with confidence, and here he is admitting because he had no father, he had issues with confidence and he had issues with discipline. This is not me saying this. This is Tupac Shakur. I'll give you another unimpeachable quote. This is from Kwesi Mfume, who used to be the head of the NAACP. He's one of the rare black leaders that deigned to come on the Larry Elder Show in 20 years. I said, Mr. Mfume, as between the presence of white racism or the absence of black fathers, which poses the bigger threat to the black community? And he said, without a beat, the absence of black fathers. I'm Larry Elder. Salute.